What's up, everyone? Nick Arapkalis here, and welcome to this YouTube video. Are you looking to advertise successfully on Bing so that you're spending less money than you're making, therefore generating a big ROI? Well, if that is the case, you're certainly at the right place. I'm going to show you exactly how to set up some campaigns so that they are structured successfully so that we can start looking at the data and really starting to see where is the ROI coming from. Where can we shut down some things and really optimize it to where we are getting a much more positive result than a lot of people can experience within advertising, within Bing and other platforms. So we're going to jump all into that here on this video. So if that's what you're looking for, you're certainly at the right place. Okay. Now, first, before we do get started with that type of stuff, I just want to talk about one quick thing is if you're not doing Bing already, I'm sure you're looking into it now. But if you're not, now is the time to do it. Okay, it's a very untapped resource and it's a big resource. Okay, I was just at an event a couple weeks ago, and they were discussing Bing quite a bit. And I've been using Bing for a couple years now, been getting solid results for quite some time now. But I didn't realize how big it was. Okay, Google gets over a billion visitors per month, okay? But what I didn't realize is Bing is not that far behind it. In combinations with Yahoo and AOL, which those are the partners within Bing, so when you are advertising on Bing, you're advertising on those networks as well. In combination with all those, they are reaching around 800 million visitors a month, okay? So you can see that's not that far behind. So now is time to start using Bing, because it's just going to continue to get bigger and bigger, and more people are going to start using it, and it's going to get more competitive. So it's very untapped right now. So I strongly recommend that you start jumping into it. Okay. So I just want to lay that down real quick. I'm going to show you how to set up campaigns. First of all, set up how you can track conversions, because for me, it's very important to know how much am I paying per opt-in, email opt-in. That's an important metric for me to look at, so that I know that I'm building my list. Yes, sales are great right away, but I want long-term sustainability with my business, and how I'm going to do that is with building a list. So that's exactly how I'm going to show it to you here. Other people might do it a little bit differently, but I think this is the best way, and this is the way I'm doing it. Okay, so come into our campaign manager, and basically what you want to do before you set up a campaign, before you do any of that type of stuff, what you want to do is come down here and come into conversion tracking. Okay, click on that. And now you want to create what's called a UET tag. Okay, so you just click on the UET tag over here. Create UET tag. Create UET tag. And we'll just name it here. We'll do Bing Tester. Okay, and we want to copy this. Okay, we're going to copy this, put it on a notepad. And keep that right there. Oops. There we go. All right, so we'll keep that right there for right now. I'll show you where to put that here in a second. But here's the other thing you want to do. You want to click on conversion goal, create a conversion goal. And this is going to show like when you're actually getting a lead. Okay. So I'll just name it the same thing, Bing Tester. And this is just for your information. You want to click on destination URL, because when they hit the thank you page, that's what we're tracking. Is when they hit the thank you page, that is when the UET tag is going to fire, and that's when it's going to show you got a conversion. And then here's where you want to put the actual URL of the page. So here I'm using lead pages, so I'll just show you how I'm using it. This is my essentially thank you page. I just made a little test thank you page for this. I'll copy that. Typically, you want to put this on your own domain as well, but just for example purposes, we'll use the lead page domain right now. But as of right now, they also work, because Bing is a lot less strict than Google and other advertising platforms. I don't assign a value because it's just a lead. It's not a sale or anything. And then I just do unique, and then I will do the Bing Tester. Okay, I'll save that. Okay, and boom, we're ready to go. Now we want to come back and get our UAT tag we had here, copy this, and then we're going to paste it into our Thinky page. Okay, so in lead pages, you click on lead pages, your tracking codes, and then you would just paste it right here. Boom, you're all set to go, and save it, and boom, there we're good to go. So you're good to go there. Let me show you what this like actually looks like when you start actually generating conversions. Okay, we'll come to one of my campaigns, and keyword. So you come over here. You'll see conversions, okay? That is leads, okay? It's 28, these are all my keywords, so it's showing how many leads I was getting and how much it was costing per lead, okay? So that's what's gonna look like when you after you set this up correctly, and now we set up a campaign. So let's go ahead and set up a campaign. Come back into campaigns, all campaigns. And we'll create a new one. So here we want to do conversions in my website. That's how we're going to track. That's how it's going to show actual conversions there. We'll just stick with the same name, Bing Tester, whatever you want to call it, whatever budget you want. I choose the top 5 English speaking countries. So, and this is how I do all my advertising anyways. Because I want people that are speaking English that have money. Okay. That's what you want. So you target United States, United Kingdom, Australia, New Zealand, and then Canada. So those are the 5 that you want to target. United States, Australia, New Zealand, United Kingdom, and Canada. Those are the ones that you want to do. And here's the big thing is you want to do people in your targeted locations only, not people searching or viewing pages about your targeted location. You want people that are from Bangladesh searching stuff about US. You don't want to target those people. Okay. So you save and go to the next step. And here's where you want to put in your keywords. Okay. I'm going to show you a very simple way to do it, because the key here is just putting in a bunch of keywords and then just seeing what works, okay? You let the market tell you what's gonna work. You don't decide what's gonna work beforehand. So you just wanna throw a bunch of keywords in there, and then later you'll find out like, okay, this is costing $1 per lead, this is costing $3 per lead, this is costing $5 per lead. So you wanna cut off the ones that are too much, and you wanna keep the ones that are going well. So what you wanna do is come into the keyword planner. Keyword planner. So this is just this is by Google. I'm sure you have a good idea on what this is. Basically, it's free, a free tool to use. It's easy to use, and it's going to give you a lot of keywords. There's other different programs out there that will show you keywords, but I think this is probably the best one. So obviously, you'd make it relevant to whatever it is that you're offering. So let's say we're going to go within the diet niche. So let's say how to lose weight. Okay. Get ideas. So you can see that how to lose weight gets, and this is on Google, so it's a little bit different on Bing. Bing won't get this amount of search volume, but it gives you an idea. Okay. Now what you can do is you can simply just add all. So you can grab like all this type of stuff and just, there's going to be 518 different, 19 keywords. So you can just add all, put that in there. And then I'll show you what happens. So add it over here, and then you can just click on that. You can click copy. Okay. This is a very simple way to do it. I strongly recommend that you just start out this way and just then kind of go from there. I'll show you some other ways in future videos on how to do some more keywords, but just to keep it basic right now, we'll just do it this way. I've done it this way before. I actually did it this way one before, and I started getting leads within like 5 minutes. It was kind of crazy. But yeah, I mean, you simply can just do that. So you can just paste the keywords in here. you can go through here and see like things that probably aren't that relevant. So like WT loss, that probably isn't going to be relevant. It's probably not going to be some a keyword you want to have in there. So you can just go in there and look at through all this. But again, you're just checking to see like, is it converting? Is it creating me leads? Is it converting leads for cost effectiveness? Yeah, I would just strongly recommend that you just do that. So you can just put in ad set one or whatever you want to name it. It doesn't really matter. You just save and go to the next step. All right, so here's where you want to create your ad. You want to click on create ad. And this is really simple, okay? You just put in your URL, whatever it is that you're promoting. I'll just put this link in there just so we can move forward with it. But here's where you want to put your ad copy. Okay. And a thing that you can do is you can come over to Bing and get ideas from Bing. So type in how to lose weight. And you can look at all these different ads that come up. Slim Fast Weight Loss Challenge. Quickly drop 30 pounds in 3 weeks. Easy weight loss. Slimming aid, diet supplement, weight loss, weight management, weight loss and keep it off. Shark, like a bunch of different stuff. Like, so this would probably be a decent ad. So quickly drop 30 pounds in 3 weeks. We could just simply copy that or just kind of take something from it. Like quickly drop, and we could change it up, maybe 20 pounds work in 2 weeks. Or, you know, just play with it, okay? You got to test out different things. And then just saying, learn the secret now. Obviously, again, you just have to play with it and just click here to watch free video that shows exactly how. Whatever it is that you want to do. It's obviously going to be relevant to whatever you are promoting. So I'll put my link right in there. Final URL, paste that in there, and boom, there you go. So then you can just save that and keep that, but I strongly recommend that you also split test this as well. So you say save and create another, and then you can change it and do the 30 pounds in 3 weeks. And you could save and create another, and you could say learn the secret with an exclamation mark. Like, you could just try a bunch of different little things, and then eventually you'll come back to all the data and you'll see like which one is working the best. So then you just come down, save, and go to the next step. And here's where you want to set your bid. Okay, I typically like to stick around 30 to 40 cents. Not saying that that's what it's going to cost, but that's how much you're willing to spend. Okay, I do keep it at enhanced CPC. It's just what I do. So you can start at 20, 30, 40 cents. But basically what you're going to be looking at is looking at your data and being like, okay, am I getting clicks? Am I getting impressions? Am I getting clicks? Am I getting conversions? If that number isn't going up, then you want to increase your bid on the specific keywords. Okay. So, I'll show you what I mean here in a second. So we'll just go with 40 cents for right now. Make sure this is all good. You can check your devices, your ad schedule, location, ad distribution. I always keep it on all search networks. See, I showed you before, I was talking about before, Bing, AOL, and Yahoo are the syndicate, are the search partners. So I just keep it that. And then you can, you know, based on the data that you start accumulating, you can change stuff on here, like which places are giving you the best ROI, which devices are giving the best ROI. But in the beginning, I recommend you just start out with, you know, very broad, and then you'll eventually see what's working. So you click save, got it. You'll wait for it to be approved. And in my experience, it has been approved very quickly. I've never really had a campaign not be approved. The only thing that doesn't get approved sometimes is some of the keywords, like specific companies don't allow you to bid on their keywords. So sometimes that gets caught up in here, but it looks like we're good. So basically what you'll see is like, you'll be looking at all these keywords, and then you'll see, okay, I'm getting some clicks, I'm getting some impressions, and then you'll come over here and you're like, oh, I'm getting conversions as well. Tell me how much I'm paying per conversion. And so if like on this one, if you're paying like $15 a lead, you don't want to keep that one. So you would like pause this. Okay. So that's really the rundown on Bing advertising. I think just with that alone, it's going to help you get some solid results. Like I said, I created a campaign just like this before and I got a lead within like the first 5 minutes and it was like a 12 cent lead. It was kind of crazy. But it works, guys. Again, I would tap into this stuff because it's just going to start getting more and more popular. And when things start getting more and more popular, it gets more competitive and there's more limitations and rules you have to follow. So right now is the time to start running Bing ads because not too many people are doing it right now. All right, guys. Well, thank you for watching this video. If you have any questions, please hit me up on social media. Those links are down in the video description. I have a Facebook group. And then if you want to go check out my free video training that shows you how I've been able to, you know, build out a six-figure business and travel the world and all that kind of cool stuff. In addition to these type of traffic strategies and stuff like that, head on over to mentorwithnick.com. That is mentorwithnick.com. There's a link down in the description as well. But thank you for watching this video. I appreciate your time and we'll see you on the next video.